Say please stand, but just hold it down. So at this point, we have a presentation of the colors and the playing of our national anthem. Following the national anthem, we ask that you would remain standing for the Mount Vernon High School. Thank you. Let's see. I lied. Don't sit down. Please stand up for the alma mater. It's my first time. I apologize. I will get better. You can be seated. Thank you to Lieutenant Colonel Salvucci and the JRTC program, Mrs. Springer and the orchestra, and Mr. Garbrandt and our senior chorale members. On behalf of the Mount Vernon City Schools Board of Education, Superintendent Mr. William Cedar Jr., Central Office Directors, Knox County Career Center, Superintendent Kathy Grinnick, Career Center Principal Elaine Robinson, and the High School Administration, I would like to welcome you to the commencement of the Class of 2022. I need to start by thanking Mount Vernon. This Energy Fieldhouse that we're sitting in was paid for by you in its entirety. Our community who took care of this. It's a facility that not only allows our students to pursue athletic excellence, but also allows for events like what we're doing today. On that note, I do want to let you know, in the event of an emergency, there's exits on the north side, two exits on the north side, two on the south, one in the southeast, and one to the west, then the main entrance. Like it's been a long time coming. Some of you longer than others, but here we are. We made it. You made it. No, we made it. You made it. Sorry. Okay. All right. There's a Columbus-based group known as Focus 3. It teaches a concept known as above the line. Through this philosophy, they teach the equation E plus R equals O. Simplified, the idea is an individual is faced with an event, the E. That event leads to the individual's response, the R. The event and response leads to an outcome. So an event plus response equals an outcome. E plus R equals O. This group of seniors has faced many difficult events over the past 4 years. They start off with the normal high school setting. We all know what happened after that, but I'm going to go through it a little bit. They then went through a pandemic. We did virtual learning, hybrid learning, and then eventually got back to the new normal high school. Throughout it all, these seniors responded. They responded by continuing to show up, by continuing to persevere through the unknown, and by continuing to stay driven and focused on their individual outcomes. Class of 2022, each of you sit here because you kept moving forward. You kept responding. As you walk across the stage today, you will be moving to your next event. A new chapter of life awaits. I personally firstly, we'd like to thank you for allowing us to be a part of your response. I also want to thank the Mount Vernon High School staff. They've also faced many events, and they've responded. Their response has led to this today. So thank you. So first of all, congratulations to all of you, but especially congratulations to the class of 2022. That's close to when I graduated, sorry. At this time, Mr. Garibrandt and Mount Vernon High School Chorale will be performing When You Wish Upon a Star. Thank you again to Mr. Garibrandt and our Mount Vernon High School Chorale. This time, I invite Senior Class President John D. Patel to the podium for the presentation of the class gift. I will also invite Superintendent Mr. William Sear Jr. to the podium for the acceptance of the class gift, and at the conclusion, to share his remarks in the class of 2022. John B. is the daughter of Chaitan and Chaitna Patel. She is a member of National Honor Society and earned a three-year academic letter. She will be attending the University of Cincinnati, majoring in Information Systems.
Good afternoon. When deciding the class of 2022 gift, class officers mutually decided to use the allotted money to paint the freshman lockers. We aim to leave the school a better place and ensure that every incoming class feels welcome to the high school. We hope that this improvement boosts school spirit and gives the incoming class something to look forward to in the years to come. Thank you.
Thank you, John D., and the class of 2022. 2022, when I first heard of that wonderful gift, I found it to be really kind of unique. Here you are ending your 4 years, and you're thinking about those freshmen coming over. And if you've ever been in our upper hallways, we have some lockers that are tucked away, and they're blue, of all things. And so for the class of 2022 to say we want to bring that spirit to our freshmen when they transition, that's an awesome gift. So thank you very, very much. Well, good afternoon. On behalf of Mount Vernon's Board of Education, it's my pleasure to welcome you to Energy Fieldhouse to celebrate and recognize the Mount Vernon High School graduating class of 2022. I would especially like to welcome the parents and family members of our graduates, both in person and watching at home, for your love and devotion have been instrumental in making this day possible. I would also like to say a special thank you to all of the teachers to my right, your left, from kindergarten to high school. Their dedication and commitment to these students are to be commended and are greatly appreciated. Finally, I'd like to congratulate you, the graduating class of 2022. 13 years ago, many of you started this journey together in kindergarten. Today, the class of 2022 consists of 276 graduates strong. The diplomas you'll receive today is testimony to your success. Congratulations. I have a good friend who loves to kayak. Tries to get out as often as he can. Last summer, he was making his way down the Cocosing River, and as he kind of turned the bend, he noticed in the bank on the side of the Cocosing River what looked like to be a piece of wood. And so he paddled over to the side, and he grabbed this piece of wood, and he noticed it was a sign. And it had all kinds of mud on it, but he threw the sign in his boat, and he headed on down and finished his run. When he got home, he cleaned up the sign, and what he saw in front of him was interesting. He sent me a picture. And as I looked at the picture of this sign, it said very simply, "Once upon a time, there was time." I looked at it again. "Once upon a time, there was time." And I had to think about it some more. You see, once upon a time, we've all heard that phrase, right? It's part of kids' fairy tales, once upon a time. But "there was time" was so simplistic that it made me think, and it finally connected with me. I realized that time is a matter of perspective. To you graduates, when you're young and ready to take on the world, time seems limitless, like an obstacle in the way of your future. We even sometimes wish time away so that we can get to the next chapter in our lives. If I asked every senior to put your hand up to say, "Did any of you get senioritis?" I'll bet many of you might have said, "Yes, I was ready to get to this day." You know, when you approach middle age and you find yourself balancing careers and family, it seems as though there just is never enough time to meet the demands of daily life. And then when you find yourself getting a little older, I like to call it more mature, because that's the area that I fit in, you begin to realize how quickly time passes by. I would bet there are some parents and even grandparents in here today that would agree with me that it seems like just yesterday they started kindergarten, scored their first goal, played in their first recital. Where has time gone? As a member of the mature crowd, I'd like to offer you just a couple brief, timely tips as you close out this chapter of your life, realizing that the best is yet to come. As I reflected upon these tips, I realize that they not only apply to you, but they may apply to all of us. Take time to embrace the journey. Far too often, we remain so fixated on the destination that we forget the joy of the journey. You see, it's in the journey where life's special moments happen. I challenge you to celebrate every successful step. Learn from every stumble and share your journey with others, and I can assure you the view from the mountaintop will be amazing. Secondly, I would say schedule time to unplug. schedule time to unplug. You see, technology can be a wonderful tool, but for meaningful contact and meaningful relationships that will help you develop, put your phone down for a while. Look up. Raise your hand. Speak. Ask. Listen. And be present. I challenge each of you to set a goal to unplug from your phone, to unplug from social media one day a week, and I believe you'll be better for it. I'm also going to ask you to carve out some time for yourself. You see, we live in an incredibly busy world. Our pace of life is often so frantic. Our minds are always so busy. We're always doing something. It will be important for you to find that right work-life balance. I challenge each of you to try something new. Learn a new language. Play a musical instrument. Volunteer for a nearby organization. Take a road trip. Maybe even learn to kayak. But do and try something new with that time you've created for yourself. I also ask that you make time for the ones you love. You see, we realize that this is your time to fly, to spread your wings, and to become successful, independent young adults. But I can tell you it gets so easy to get caught up in the day-to-day of your busy lives. Days become weeks, weeks become months. Before long, we realize how disconnected we've come from the ones we love. And you have people in this audience who love you dearly. I challenge you to visit, call, or write regularly to the ones you love. Tell them how much you appreciate them, and tell them that you love them. And finally, don't take time for granted. We know that our time is finite. It has a beginning and an end. There are no guarantees of time. So I would encourage that each of you to live each day to its fullest with no regrets. One of my favorite authors, Andy Andrews, said it like this: life itself is a privilege, but to live life to the fullest, that's a choice. Once upon a time, there was time. Class of 2022, this is your time. May God richly bless each one of you.
Thank you, Mr. Peter. Next, I'll invite Megan Chamberlain to the stage. Megan is the daughter of Charles and Rebecca Chamberlain. She was in vedette her freshman and sophomore year, key club for 4 years, French club for 3 years, and vice president of National Arts Society. She has 3-year academic letters and several Kiwanis awards, including vedette, AP comparative government economics, and French. She received the President's Education Award for the top 2% of her class. She was also voted the classmates. Her future plans are to attend Ohio University for French education and minor in linguistics so she can teach both French and English as a second language. Make a check.
General, there's been a lot of self-reflection.
on your blood and meat. But if they tell you they don't need kisses for their boo-boo, they're lying. We may say we don't need you as much as we did when we were only this tall, but we definitely still do. We need your support as we make paramount decisions about our futures. Some of us are off to college. Others are joining the workforce. Some of us are going into the military. And some of us have no idea what we want to do with the rest of our lives. And that's okay. It's perfectly fine to feel overwhelmed or out of place right now. We're all evolving in different ways at different speeds. And parents, please remember that just as we're leaving you, we're also leaving our friends, and for some of us, our hometown. This is a big change for us. One we've been looking forward to, and one that seems to have taken forever to arrive, but one we didn't expect to be over with so quickly. And let's be honest, none of us really knows what we want to do with the rest of our lives. So let's take this one step at a time. This is just the beginning. No, but now we get to experience new and exciting things. There's nobody wants an apathetic life, so we have to embrace this change, however scary or sad it may be at times. And I want to ask something of each of you, especially those of you who have been avoiding thinking about what happens after today. Please take some time to understand yourself. Learn what brings you joy and figure out how to implement that into your future. Find a person to lean on while the world spins so fast around you. Find a hobby that you want to share with others, or maybe a concept to develop. Think of even the small things that make you thrive and expand upon that. Be open to change, learn new skills, and work on your authenticity so you can bring about changes you never knew were possible. And don't be afraid to ask for help from others. You deserve the world. Don't be afraid to take up space. Go be loud. Go live life. Go be in the present before the future catches up with you. And when it does, receive it with open arms. And my fellow peers, congratulations. You made it. I love you all. Happy graduation.
Thank you, Megan. Next, I'll invite Kelly and Kylie Workman to the stage. Kylie is the daughter of Eric Workman and Jennifer Smith. Her accomplishments during the 4 years of Mount Vernon High School include graduating with an associate's in science and being ranked in the top 10% of her class. Her future plans are to return to the COTC to get an associate's of arts with a concentration in psychology, and then head to Ohio University to pursue a bachelor's or even a master's degree in psychology.
Let me speak this down, I'm kind of small. First off, I'd like to say thank you. Thank you to Mount Vernon High School for everything you've done. Thank you to my family. I love you all. And a special thank you to the class of 2022, and a special thank you to Jaden Christine. A baby's first step, a child's first day at school, and a teen's first time behind the wheel of a car. The human life is made of minute yet monumental milestones that last a lifetime. Today, the class of 2022 will celebrate yet another milestone. Except this milestone brings with it a list of questions. Some of you are asking, did I do my best? Others are asking, am I going to remember the lessons I've learned? And then there's a small percentage that are asking, do I work tonight? But there's one question that looms over all of our heads today. What am I supposed to do now? And it is this daunting yet exciting question that has inspired me to speak with you all today. And it is my great honor to present to you my answer, the three P's of life. The first P is passion. Up until this point, we've all been forced to learn lessons, each as unique as they are important from one another. And we've used these lessons to guide our decisions. Our desired careers went from princesses and knights to teachers and astronauts to doctors and even lawyers. But now that the day has come to decide, you may have realized you don't actually know what you want to do. But it would be the greatest injustice to ignore the common denominator in all of your decisions. Your passion for each career path has never wavered. Passion is what ignites the fire within the soul. Passion is what sets life in motion. Passion is what pushes people to do the unthinkable. After all, the 26th President of the United States, Theodore Roosevelt, once said, "Far and away, the best prize life offers is the chance to work hard at work worth doing." Work hard at what you believe is working hard for. Choose what ignites the fire within your soul. Choose what sets your life in motion. Choose what pushes you to do the unthinkable. Choose passion. The second P of three is perspective. Perspective is crucial to navigating through life. You will struggle, you will thrive, you will have lows, and you will have highs. The one thing that you will carry with you through it all is your perspective. The American actor Chris Pine once said, "The only thing you have control over sometimes is your perspective. You don't have control over your situation, but you have a choice in how you view it." Ladies and gentlemen, the lens in which we see the world is not the same for everyone. Some view the world as taunting and terrifying. Others view it as exciting and exhilarating. It's all about how you look at the world. Your perspective can adjust, it can become inspired by others, and you may even need to change your perspective at times. But at the end of the day, your perspective is how you see the world. Look and see and find what you want to find. The world is beautiful and the world is big. Please see it as such. Lastly, it's the third P, and possibly the most important P of all, presence. One of the most beautiful but contradictory gifts that life offers is time. Time is always being spent but can never be refunded. So the best way to defy the cruelty of time is to be present in the moment. Be present in your career, be present in your community, and be present with your loved ones. Your presence is absolutely essential when it comes to human connection. Be there with the ones you love. I promise you will not regret it for a single second. And be present in this moment right now. Take a deep breath, exhale, look around you, and just take in the moment. Remember this feeling, and remember the regimen you just did to get it, so that you can repeat it throughout all your life's cherished moments. Take a deep breath, exhale, look around you, and take in the moment. As I close out my speech, I want to remind you all of a song you may have heard. It's written by Lucas Graham, and the title is 7 Years. Once, I was 7 years old. Soon, I'll be 60 years old. Class of 2022, once we were 7 years old. And soon, we will be 60 years old. And as the years fly by and my hair begins to gray, I will look forward to seeing where the three P's take all of us. Be passionate in all your endeavors. Keep your perspective with you. And be present for every cherished moment. Thank you.
Thank you, Kylie. At this time, I would like to take a moment to bring attention to the following groups of students. When I call these groups up, I ask that you stand up and give a round of applause. First off, our students participated in the Global Scholars Program. Now, there's some of you out there. Next up, the students who received their associate's degree. Next, any student who graduated through our Digital Academy program. To join our nation's armed forces. On behalf of the faculty and administration of Mount Vernon High School, I'd like to call the class of 2022 to receive their diplomas. John B. Chetan Patel. Olivia Ann Reddy. Sophia Catherine Percy. Avery Morgan Rudder. Alexander Logan Murray. Megan Sue Chamberlain. Kylie Diane Workman. Ian Tyler Acker. Ella Danielle Acker. Dylan Michael Adams. Olivia Diane Adams. Isabella K. Adrian. Maria Guadalupe Arizo Moreno. Chase Lucas Bagwell. Hayden Andrew Baker. Tori Lynn Bauer. Devin Daniel Beckett. Nolan William Allen Belcher. Christine Grace Bell. Trevor Wayne Bell. Connor William Benedetti. Ashley Marie Berg. Holden Elijah Lila. Riley Logan Blueball. Marcus Allen Bradley. Joseph David Vernon. Bo Brian Bridges. Hallie Elise Briscoe. McKenna Paige Brokaw. Ethan Ryan Brooks. Julian Adam Burgess. Emily Nicole Burke. Jocelyn Lee Ludon Burkey. Cameron Kathleen Bush. Alyssa K. Fisher. Logan Tyler Beinort. Quentin Matthew Bird. Aaliyah Marie Calkins. Emma Marie Calkins. Chase Robert Camillo. Christian Robert Cardenas. Savannah Caitlin Carpenter. Lillian Willow Carrington. Bruce Raymond Michael Lee Glover. Dakota Edward Chadwick. Emma Carrie Cheek. Jaden Allen Shane Christine. Addison May Christopher. Ethan David Clark. Elizabeth Alexis Klein. Caitlin Dominique Coker. Aaron Kelly Jones. Victoria Madison Cook. Yeah. Ryan Lee Cornell. Kayla Sue Cross. Nathaniel Connor Dale. William Jeffrey Daly. Abigail Nicole Davis. Andrea Constance Dayton. Hayes Kristen Dean. Emily Marie Decker. Jacob Aaron Deaver. Sierra Marie Durr. Elizabeth Ann Deal. Anna Grace Den. Conyer Nathaniel Douglas. Dylan James Dow. Taylor Catherine DeBusky. Jersey Nicole Duffy. Faith Leanne Elliott. Kate Broderick Ellis. Julia Renee Ellis. Lillian Jo Earl. Olivia Grace Ferguson. Andrew Daniel Fitzpatrick. Tennessee J. Foster. Taylor Ann Fraley. James Bryce Frazee. Robert Austin Frazee. Peyton Morgan Fritz. Joshua Allen Fry. Kara Lynn Garsha. Mason Eugene Clancy. Owen Layton Gleason. Thaisa Marie Gonzalez Perez. Xavier James Niemo. Mays Lewis Gunderson. Dryden Lane Hager. Cameron Carson Hager. Zachary Michael Hajar. Jocelyn Jerry Hall. Mishadai Victoria Hall. Jonathan David Hammond. Dylan Jason Hartman. Caleb Nolan Hartz. Adam Michael Howe. Ashton Marie Hayes. Hannah Haven Henry. Bryce Davin Henson. Yvonne Saeed Hernandez Love. Kate Clifton Harris. Landon Avery Holt. Zachary J. Huggins. McKenna Elizabeth Hughes. Madison Renee Iacono. Thomas Lee Jennings. Gage Timoa Johnson. Allison Jade Jones. Isaiah Jeffrey Jones. Morgan Heidi Jones. Joseph Daniel Kennedy. Logan James Kirby. Jasmine Paige Knapp. Benjamin William Kramer. Leanna Gabriel Kuhn. Adam Brian Landon Jr. Connor Jackson Lane. William Joseph Lehman. Devin Kyle Leader. Jada Ann Legro. Jasmine Marie Lewis. Mason Michael Lewis. Harrison Clinton Lingle. Andrew Bryce Littleton. John Amos Lowe the Fourth. Ashlyn Michaela Lutz. Sydney May Lyons. Alec Robert McDonald. Emma Faith Markham. Riley Ann Marston. Connor David Mark. Ryan Lee Martin. Adam West Mason. Lance David Matthews. Gabriel Lee Mayo Shannon. Brianna Marie McCluskey. Lily Elena McCall. Madison Grace McGo. Anna Michelle McMahon. Haley Alexandra Middleton. Zachary Bryant Miller. Maya Lene Moody. Isabella Marie Moore. Logan Timothy Moore. Cheyenne Dawn Moran. Maddie Noel Morrison. Elgie Muka. Zachary Theodore Mullen. Mackenzie Ann Murphy. Hayden Carson Murray. Emily Nicole Meyer. Linda Ellen Nace. Joy Marie Nybarger. Lydia Denise Nybarger. Jessica Nicole. Nicole Neuer. Chloe Mae O'Brien. Lucy Morgan Ogle. Liliana Nicole Patty. Allison Suzanne Page. Braden Gary Keegan Paul. Reagan Marie Parks. Lakeland Victoria Parnell. Robert Zion Payne. Beckett Deshaun Elkins. Brandon Avalos Perez. Anai Perez Ramirez. Braden Allen Hurd. Jillian Elizabeth Peterson. Spencer Michael Pugh. Kennedy Grace Blank. Madison Michelle Pope. Riley Jean Pope. Weston Rockwell Porter. Asia Lynn Price. Abigail Elizabeth Priest. Kayla J. Proker. Michael Thomas Pruitt. Elena Quinn Forbes. Jared Michael Forbes. Duanette Chadriel Ramos Perez. Megan Mary Randall. Wesley James Reardon. Veronica Ann Reyes. Vernon Gage Reynolds. Caleb Andrew Reinsfeld. Anna Catherine Rodiback. Damian Michael Rice. Ethan Samuel Ritchie. Lauren Mackenzie Briscoe. Carter Lane Rutherford. Brian Mitchell Cibula. Dylan Michael Stain. Michaela Cheyenne Slosser. Kaylee Dale Showalter. Madeline Jane Stencil. Jackson James Slater. Caleb Dalton Smith. Devin Nicole Smith. Jordan Isabel Smith. Nehemiah Turing Smith. Emma Brace Snow. Zachary Tyler Snyder. Colton John Spurgeon. Dustin Wayne Starmer. Jillian Lee Stoffer. Trey Ryan Stetler. Jacob Andrew Stitcher. Jared Albert Stitcher. Nathaniel Lane Stradley. Faith Hunter Strait. Alexis Noel Strong. Kaylee K. Stallings. Emma Jo Summerfield. Riker Kennedy Swayze. Robert Lee Colt Swint Jr. Sophia Nora Takrori. Emma Lane Calvin. Abigail Grace Taylor. Isaac Edgar Scott Taylor. Logan Seth Taylor. Mitchell Abel Taylor. Ethan Matthew Temple. Marissa K. Tharp. Lily Liberty Rose Stoner. Zachariah Tyler Thomas. Isabel Grace Tooley. Ethan Michael Travis. Jacob Lewis Tucker. Philip Dwight Tyson. Cameron Annette Van Gundy. Corbin Denton Byrne. Annabelle Stacy Wagner. Abigail McKenzie Wagner. Evelyn Michelle Opal Walker. Blake Douglas Ward. Zachary Allen Ward. Eric Daniel Weber Jr. Tobias William Wells. Andrew Joseph White. Benjamin Mark Woodrick. Brendan Michael Williams. Brittany Nicole Williams. Caitlin Renee Winger. Taylor Lynn Yarman. Amanda Cooper Yoakum. Evan Lee Zinkon. Class of 2022, please stand. At this time, I'd like to call the class officers to stand in the front of the class for the changing of the tassel. Meeting the standards of the Mount Vernon City School Board of Education, as well as the state of Ohio, and on behalf of the faculty and administration of the Mount Vernon High School, I would like to present to you the class of 2022.
As this momentous occasion comes to an end, there is one tradition that will never end or change. The turning of our tassel.
As our time has come to an end at Mount Vernon High School, we will transition to a new chapter in our lives. This is just the beginning of our lives, and this marks the start of our new chapter.
The turning of our tassel represents the significant event in our lives, one that we will continue to remember forever.
At this time, please turn your tassel from right to left.